ditch, they get behind me on the other side of the good sized creek going on down there. I can see the water. It's only about 10 yards. I'm loading the deer across the creek and come out here to feed. I got pictures of that big acorn standing right there. My trail camera's right on the inside of that pine tree. My shoulders messed up a lot with the crossbow this year. I'd like for my first deer with the crossbow to be a good one. I'll take what I can get, though. Kinda holding off for him. I got that tree sprayed up with Bowana's fatal obsession scent. Hoping that'll stop him from a shot. The wind's not real good at switching around. That big hurricane coming in. It's the second day of deer season. It's been a while since I shot one, so I'm ready. Bring him home.
The hunt for the Big 8 actually started in early summer. I could tell right off he was special for the area. He hung out with another good-sized buck I called the 9-pointer. In early bow season, the 9-pointer came by one of my trail cameras, kind of sickly looking, head hanging down, mouth open. A few days later, I found him dead, laying in the creek. My guess, it was probably EHD. There's a lot of no-see-ums in the area. But I put in a lot of hard work, so it was heartbreaking to see him go like that. But regardless, I still got a tough job ahead of me. The Big 8 was still alive. The wind's in my face and blowing behind me. As long as he comes in front of me, I'll be all right. It's just a little buck getting ready to cross the creek. Looks like my plans are working. Whoops, there goes the Big 8. Well, at least part of my plan is working. This hunt could be over before it really gets started. They're moving downwind. The only thing I can think of is to pull out my bow hunter's fatal obsession scent. Maybe to throw them off base. It has before. I know this buck too. He's not the big eight, but he's a pretty good one. He's smelling it. I may have him fooled. He's getting a good whiff of it. That's where I walked in. I had it all over my boots. He's right under me, and there's another buck farther out. He's the one that crossed the creek with the big eight. He's around here somewhere. I see another deer. It's back behind him, through the trees. It's him. It's on, boys. I'll put my knee up to rest on. Looks like he's going to come out in this hole. I usually take the first available shot, but the arrow rises and drops to its target. The limb's in the way. I ranged the little buck at 32. I figure he's about 3 yards farther. 35 yards, here we go. Thank you.
man, that worked out perfect. They got downwind of me. So I started spraying BFO all over the bushes and everything, the bottom of my feet. And they disappeared on down that way. I said, well, it's over with. I done some grunting and a snort wheeze and stuff. Next thing I know, about 15 minutes later, that nine pointer that I didn't want to get mixed up with and shoot him got right up under my tree. It was hard, but I held off on him. I was wanting to get some blood on the ground real bad, but I didn't do it. Next thing I know, I saw the other buck out here in front of me, and that's the one that was with the big eight point. I said, well, he's just standing way back. He's coming too. And he did. Come out there about 35 yards. It looked like a good shot. I reviewed the tape. It looked like a pinwheel. We run into the thicket on the other side, right behind the shopping center. He's probably 30 yards from the back fence of that shopping center over there. I'm gonna climb down and go look for him. I'm all tore up. But that BFO worked good.
Riding the truck.